This is Nine News with Sophie Walsh.
Good morning. There have been multiple arrests, abattoirs have been invaded and major roads shut down as vegan activists stage nationwide protests. Stephanie Anderson is in Melbourne CBD where the streets have been blocked off for hours.
Well, after more than 3 hours of protesting, police have managed to remove a large group of activists from the centre of this busy Melbourne intersection. From 7 this morning, more than 100 protesters shut down where Flinders and Swanston streets meet, calling for action on animal rights.
Animals are suffering in ways that most of us cannot even imagine, and it's an absolute climate emergency. So it's an animal emergency and a climate emergency.
Staged right out the front of Flinders Street Station, the protest was part of a national day of action. It closed the intersection to trams and traffic, infuriating some commuters.
I think they're a bunch of idiots.
After more than 2 hours of action, police moved in.
Everyone move.
Using an angle grinder to cut protesters free from vans, helping to block the intersection. Before others were handcuffed and taken into police custody.
It is shameful. I mean, this is just another form of activism that I think that runs against the national interest. And the national interest is people being able to farm their own land.
It took this very large group of police more than an hour to completely clear the intersection, allowing for traffic and trams to resume.
Well, we're still waiting for an election to be called, but two different opinion polls have shown Labor is pulling ahead of the coalition. Ellie Walsh is live for us this morning in Canberra. Ellie, both polls signal Scott Morrison is heading for defeat.
Yeah, that's right, Sophie. Ask most politicians and on the record, they'll tell you they don't pay any attention to polls. But this week, I think there'd be little doubt that they'd be looking very closely at those numbers. And let's take you straight to them now. If we take a look at the Ipsos poll in the Sydney Morning Herald and The Age, the gap has widened 53-47 on the two-party preferred basis. News poll, though, paints a different picture. The coalition now just 4 points behind. Let's go to the preferred PM stakes, and support for both leaders has dropped in the Ipsos poll. And then if you move on to the news poll, support for Scott Morrison is up 3 points. So what's the takeaway here? Well, no matter how you look at it, no matter which poll you look at, the short story is Scott Morrison is running from a long way behind. And if an election were to be held today, it would mean defeat for the government. But we still have no firm date as to when we will head to the polls, Sophie. May 18 is firming as the favourite. And while we're still waiting for an election to be called, we're certainly already in campaign mode, and we have been really since the end of last year. But both Scott Morrison and Bill Shorten today in Brisbane, you can see on your screen, donning the high-vis, both touring two factories. And there are around 8 Liberal Party and National seats on the line in Queensland alone, and Labor looks set to pick up some of them. Sophie, as the saying goes, you win Queensland, you win government.
Okay, Ellie, thank you for the update. The US government may file criminal charges over that leaked phone call between Donald Trump and Malcolm Turnbull. Attorney General William Barr will reportedly have the task of working out who was behind the 2017 bombshell which rocked the two nations. The tense conversation ended in the US president hanging up on former Australian Prime Minister due to disagreements about asylum seeker policies. There's a major manhunt in Sydney for a convicted double murderer who dumped his ankle monitor in the city's eastern suburbs and made a run for it while on parole. Hannah Sinclair has the details.
Damian Peters has now been on the run for more than 19 hours after dumping his tracking anklet near a monastery behind me here in Kensington. The 50-year-old is a convicted double murderer and is on parole. He took off from Randwick's Prince of Wales Hospital just after 4 o'clock yesterday afternoon. Police were immediately notified and a search was launched. About an hour later, they received information that his electronic monitoring anklet had been tracked here to Kensington, about 2 kilometres from the hospital. And we understand it was about 8:30 last night that police found it dumped in bushes near the church.
That's a bit concerning, especially if they could be hiding in a boat. There's a boat over there. It could be hiding in the boat. There's 5 acres of land there, and there's a lot of nooks and crannies and bush. So, yeah, technically it could be anywhere.
Now, it was in 2002 that Damian Peters was jailed for 21 years for murdering and dismembering his two male lovers. He was released on parole in late 2016. Police are this morning still searching for the convicted killer and have released a photo of him to the public. They also say he has tattoos on his right and left arms. They are urging the public not to approach him if they spot him, but instead to call 000 immediately.
Hannah Sinclair reporting there. Four people have died on Victoria's roads following a horror weekend of crashes across the state. Overnight, a 5-year-old girl and a 70-year-old woman were killed near Mildura after two cars collided on the Murray Valley Highway. 89 lives have been lost on Victorian roads this year alone. Alarmingly, that's 31 more than the same time last year. Police are searching for the driver of a car who failed to stop following a collision with a motorbike in Sydney South. Emergency services were called to the intersection of Forest Road and Jersey Avenue at Penshurst following reports of the crash just after 1 a.m. this morning. The male rider and female passenger of the motorbike were treated at the scene and taken to hospital in a stable condition. Three men are on the run after a violent home invasion on the Gold Coast where a man was shot in the head and his brother was attacked with a hammer. Isabel Mullen has the details.
Two Gold Coast brothers, 27-year-old Reece King and his brother Brendan, remain here at the Gold Coast University Hospital in stable conditions. They were rushed here at around midday yesterday after a violent home invasion in Robina. Reece was shot in the face while his brother Brendan was hit in the head with a hammer. Nine News understands Reece will undergo surgery at the hospital today, but thankfully both of the brothers' injuries aren't life-threatening. Police are now looking for three men who drove off in a black hatchback. They are still on the run. Authorities don't believe the attack was bikie-related, but haven't ruled it out.